The information in this podcast is for educational purposes only. You should consult your doctor, specialist, or physical trainer for advice on your physical wellness goals before you plan to follow any of the suggestions or recommendations in this podcast.
Hello!
Hola!
Merhaba!
Welcome to the
Astro About Wellness podcast.
Join me, Shazana Sunny, and the Astro Duo,
Asfar Azman
and Azima Azman,
your host from New York. Let's strive to educate, regenerate, and elevate family institutions through optimal productivity and wellness education,
one episode at a time.
Are you ready
to listen to inspirational stories of trust, respect, acceptance, integrity,
love,
and social responsibility for multicultural families and special needs communities?
Sit back and relax and be inspired by the awesome people that we highlight in the first segment of the podcast.
Welcome back to the Astrio About Wellness podcast. This episode is co-sponsored by Hadi Kamsani and my dad, Azman Ripin. Thank you and may God bless you.
Upon you.
You are listening to the 21st episode of the first season of the podcast with me, Shazana, and the Astro Duo, Asfar and Azima. As of July 3rd, 2021, we have published 20 full episodes.
Woohoo!
We have recorded 812 all-time downloads. Thanks to all our listeners out there.
Yay!
We are grateful to Almighty God for all His blessings and to each and every one of our listeners out there, as well as our volunteers and guest speakers. Let's listen to some highlights from
us first generation ceremony and the Reader Circle with Ivy Niao.
Mohammed Akbar Shami bin Mohammed Azman.
MashaAllah. Move your tassel from right to left. I present you the class of 2021. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Asfar!
Woohoo!
Next, my teenage boy superhero has a special announcement to make. Take it away, Asfar!
Are you looking to be entertained, inspired, and educated on ways to help you and your family embark on your journey to optimal productivity and wellness? Do you care about people and culture, multicultural families, and an inclusive world where special needs communities have a place in this world? Support Astrio About Wellness podcast by Astrio Wello LLC, a special space for every voice. Join host Shazana Sani and the Astrio duo, me, Asfar Azman, and Azima Azman, as we build a special community that strives to educate, regenerate, and elevate family institutions through optimal productivity and wellness education, one episode at a time. Become our patron and gain access to the new Astrio Wello Club membership privileges. Every dollar counts. Each dollar gifted by you to Astrio About Wellness podcast will be channeled towards the production of at least 20 pre-recorded weekly episodes, that is 15 to 25 minutes per episode per season, over 5 months, and quarterly live talk shows for each season, free for all families across the globe. Patrons only premium content and membership rewards vary according to the monthly amount pledge, ranging from $199 to $99 per month. Pledge amount will go towards sponsoring the podcast production, equipment, and administrative cost. Honorarium for show hosts, scriptwriter, producer, director, collaborators, podcast equipment, cast and Astroworld Club membership administration, sales, marketing, and podcast, audio, sound, and video design, editing, publishing, and more. For inquiries, contact our founder director, Shazana Sani, by her email, shazana@astrovelo.com, or you can contact her using Astrovelo's Telegram, +1 area code 518-423-3590. Thank you. May God bless you.
We hope that you will be a patron. To make a pledge, click on the link to our patron page at https://patron.podbean.com/astroaboutwellness ASKTRIOABOUTWELLNESS. As part of the summer fundraiser, let's listen to some highlights from
the Reader Circle with Ivy. Yeah.
Okay, I can bring you a hot tip about complementary colors. So again, we revisit the color wheel. When colors are used opposites to each other, that's called complementary. We see a lot of dark colors like this in mid-century modern, dark blue and teal. These are, we would say, quite rich, but rich and dark colors. And the complementary opposite of teal on the color wheel is coral. And you know, coral is like light orangey pink. So that's the opposite. So when they are paired, the effect becomes very dramatic. As a color that was popular in the mid-century, when combined with gold tones, it will create that vintage look. So the hot tip in the color chapter is to use opposites. You know, that's why the red, black and white, these are opposites. Pink and green, they are opposites. Teal and coral, again, opposites. So always think what's the next color, like blue and green are beside each other, so they go together, or the opposite. So that's another hot tip for the chapter on color.
Thank you, Ivy.
That's it for segment one this week.
Stay tuned to the next episode. Coming up next,
in the second segment of the podcast, we'll learn about productivity and the nine dimensions of wellness: physical, emotional, environmental, spiritual, social, intellectual, mental, occupational, and financial wellness.
So we can survive and thrive in this unpredictable world. Hey, we are now in segment two of the podcast with a fresh lineup of guest speakers. As promised in episode 20 and our bonus episode last week, we will now focus on emotional, social, and mental wellness for families. To help us achieve our goal, we have a special guest from Singapore.
Now it's time to welcome our special guest, Brother Muhammad Ali. Welcome to the show, Brother Ali.
Thank you.
Tell us about who you are and what you love to do in your professional and personal life.
I am Muhammad Ali Mahmood. I'm currently in private practice as a social work consultant. And what I do is to help organizations that provide social services to improve their social work programs or to come up with new ones. Among other services, I also provide clinical supervision for social workers, facilitate support groups, and conduct training, as well as workshops on family life. I also teach social work at the local university as an associate faculty member. In my spare time, I enjoy reading non-fiction. I look after my wall garden. I do Sudoku when I'm traveling to meetings. And I do jigsaw puzzles on weekends.
What inspired your career choices? Medical social worker
CEO of PPIS, lecturer at SUSS, business owner of BROMOHD, the practice.
Actually, I wanted to become a teacher growing up, and somehow the calling to do social work came when I was doing my national service. In Singapore, all able-bodied men will have to do a 2-year stint in the Army, Navy, Air Force, or Civil Defense as a form of national service. During my service, my camp mates told me that I was easy to talk to about their troubles. They told me that I was a good listener and they would feel better after telling me their problems. So I figured out maybe it would be better for me to get proper training and do this professionally.
Wow!
Oh, so you discovered your strengths and passion while serving the country.
My career pathway somehow progressed through promotions, and after years of experience in the field, in 2016, I became the chief executive officer of the organization, and I have been working there since the year 2000. However, in 2019, I decided to pursue my long-abandoned goal of having my master's in social work, and I left the organization. While doing my studies, perhaps due to my vast experience, I was given the opportunity to teach undergraduates in the same university. So back then, I was both a student and a lecturer at the same time.
That's awesome!
Now, after receiving my master's, I was offered to teach more social work modules. At the same time, since I was no longer affiliated to any particular organization, other social service organizations approached me for help with their programs. So that eventually led to my setting up Bro Muhammad, the practice.
Which of the 9 dimensions of wellness have the greatest impact on you and why?
With regard to the 9 dimensions of wellness, for me, spiritual and emotional wellness have the greatest impact. I believe having spiritual and emotional wellness allows me to remain centered when I face daily challenges. I feel assured that whatever difficulties that come my way, my sense of spirituality allows me to view these difficulties differently, that I am facing these challenges to prepare me for future purpose. Hence, instead of focusing on the current problems, I usually get excited and wonder about how overcoming the challenges will give me new knowledge for the future.
Thank you, Brother Ali. Next week, we'll continue to strive to achieve emotional, social, and mental wellness with Brother Ali.
Stay tuned to the next episode.
See you next week. We've now come to the end of the show today.
If you have enjoyed our show,
like us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter
at Astrowello, AstroWello.
Send us your feedback
to Shazana@astrowello.com. Visit our website at astrowello.com and subscribe to
Astro About Wellness Podcast. Woohoo!